Okay, turning it down. Good evening, my darlings. Oh, what? Here we go. I gotta have Olivia up just a little bit. There. Like my t-shirt? Fear of the Unknown. H.P. Lovecraft. Great. This is the one t-shirt that I bought at the H.P. Lovecraft Film Festival, which I came back from today, this afternoon. I just got back from work, working at the Pony. It was a slow night, so I got off early, but the fabulous Kelly O was there. Kelly, mwah, love you. She's my sister. And David was there working the bar. David is my sister, and Tyler. And we had some pizza. Oh my god, this pizza. It's the Manhattan. Oh, there goes the fucking light. Whoops. Excuse my French. Oh. Manhattan pizza. Copa, artichoke hearts, black olives, and mushroom to die for. So we were all eating pizza. Had a lovely night, but it was slow, so I got up early, which is good because I haven't had much sleep. I was just so wide awake. I had such a good time at the H.P. Lovecraft Film Festival, and and today when I got home, I searched and searched before I left for my Chanel lip gloss, and I was certain that I'd lost it forever. And the first thing I did when I came home today, I found my Chanel lip gloss. It is to die for. Love it. So I'm a happy man. Doesn't take much to make this guy happy. But I am overjoyed. An abundance of riches. At Tony Starlight's cafe, restaurant and bar, in that's where we every night after the film festival ends, we gather there for food and drink, and they had a special menu, and the salads, if I can do this, where is it? There. The salads were Sesqua Valley salads. Isn't that cool? I was so delighted. And they had lots of just special cocktails. Like, I tried the Lagotti cocktail, but I don't like booze. So my friend Marianne finished it for me. I had a little bit. So, but such an abundance of rich. Oh, I met so many people. I met Joe, who was my roommate, and he is a really cool guy. He's been working on a Lovecraftian rock opera, and he gave me a CD, which has a part, I guess one song from the opera on it. I also found, I haven't played this yet, a CD of the Fungi from Yugga. I don't know. Composed and performed by Colin Timothy Gangong. Gangong. So I don't know if this is just music or music and a reading of the sonnets. There's only 12 tracks, so obviously it's not the entire sonnets. But I am obsessed with that sonnet cycle by Lovecraft. A wonderful young man, Dan Clore, a really cool Lovecraftian, was there. I think that was his first time there at the Lovecraft Film Festival. And he has just had a new book published by Hippocampus Press. And it's called Weird Words, A Lovecraftian Lexicon by, where's his name, Dan Clore. Oh, there goes the bloody light. See, anytime I put too many things too close, there we go, too close to the camera, the light goes out. So I'll try not to do that. Of course, I did have a bit of withdrawal because I didn't take Barbara. And so for four days, I couldn't listen to the new Barbara. And I was in agony about that. But I did get the new book. I have been waiting for this book forever. Blood Will Have Its Season, the new book by Joe Pulver. Can't wait to read that. And I just had a great time. Jessica Salmonson was there. She's just one of the most fantastic writers. And I mean, talk about poetry. I mean, Joe Pulver's book is full of poetry, but Jessica Salmonson, she writes really great novels and short stories, but she is also one of the genre's most fantastic poets. And I wish someone would bring out a collection of her poetry, a nice hardcover collection of her poetry. I would just, you know, the collected poetry of Jessica Salmonson would be so fabulous. So anyway, she was there, and Laird Barron, oh my god, the incredible Laird Barron, Michael Shea, Gary Myers was there, and I had him sign my copy of House of the Worm, his Arkham House book, and he is really cool. William F. Nolan was there, and he is really very cool. He's just really cool, you know? And he was part of that scene with Charles Beaumont and Richard Matheson back in the 50s, and Jason Brock, the incredible, very talented filmmaker. He does many things, but he made a film of a documentary about Charles Beaumont, and it is fantastic. That was actually my favorite film this year in the film festival. Although I did like, there was one film version of The Haunter of the Dark, which for some strange reason was called Pickman's Muse. And but it had nothing to do with Pickman's model. It was completely The Haunter of the Dark, and that was really great. And then I came home. Oh god, I'm running out of time already. Oh yuggas. And I got, because this book, Dark, it's Dark Horse Comics were there at the convention, and so on their table, of course, they have the new book by Ellen Datlow. She's the editor of Lovecraft Unbound. I just can't wait to read that book. Fantastic book. And then I came home and I got my copies of Inhuman, Alan Kay's magazine, Inhuman number 4. And my friend Chad Hensley and I have the lead story, which is called The Pornography of Puppets. And we got a really great illustration by Alan Kazowski. And we have the lead story. Ha ha ha. Pretty damn cool. I had a fabulous time. And then I came home and I got, oh, Sister Kitty. I love this old edition of Edgar Allan Poe. Thank you so much. I love these old books. And of course, it's Poe's 200th birthday this year. It was in January, so this is great. And then I came home and I got the American Fantastic Tales, 2 volumes in a box set, edited by Peter Straub for Library of America. I've got a lot of reading to do. Okay, I need to... This is...